Gram-negative bacteria that produce extended-spectrum beta-lactamase enzymes are a global public health concern because they're resistant to antibiotics. Based on national surveillance data from 2011, the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention estimated that drug-resistant gram-negative bacteria accounted for at least 26,000 infections and 1,700 deaths annually. The treatment of choice for serious infections caused by extended-spectrum beta-lactamase-producing gram-negative bacteria is carbapenems. However, increased use of carbapenems may select for carbapenem resistance in gram-negative bacilli, which currently represents the greatest threat in terms of antibiotic resistance. Some observational studies have suggested that combination beta-lactam-beta-lactamase inhibitor antibiotics, such as piperacillin-tazobactam, may be clinically effective for treating infections caused by extended-spectrum beta-lactamase-producing gram-negative bacteria. This week's issue of JAMA has a non-inferiority trial looking at Pip-Tazo as carbapenem-sparing therapy in patients with bloodstream infections caused by ceftriaxone-resistant E. coli or Klebsiella pneumoniae. The researchers randomly assigned hospitalized patients with at least one blood culture positive for ceftriaxone-resistant, Pip-Tazo-susceptible E. coli or Klebsiella to IV Pip-Tazo or meropenem for a minimum of 4 days, up to a maximum of 14 days, with the total duration determined by the treating clinician. The primary outcome was all-cause mortality at 30 days after randomization. Moving on to the results. The 30-day mortality rate was 12.3% for patients treated with Pip-Tazo, compared with 3.7% for patients treated with meropenem. The difference did not meet the non-inferiority margin of 5%. So the authors conclude the findings do not support the use of Pip-Tazo as carbapenem-sparing therapy in the setting of drug-resistant E. coli or Klebsiella bloodstream infection. Two editorialists in this week's issue say the study leaves several questions unanswered, including whether Pip-Tazo would be more effective if administered as an extended infusion, and whether similar combination beta-lactam-beta-lactamase inhibitor antibiotics are non-inferior to carbapenems for empirical treatment of bacteremia, or for treatment of non-bacteremic extended-spectrum beta-lactamase-producing bacterial infection.